programs cannot communicate with each other. Any process can be in one of the following five states. First state of the process is new state. A process is said to be new state if it is being created. The newly created process, it will be stored in the first state, that is the new state. Second state of the process, it is ready state. It is ready state. Third state of the process, it is execution state. Fourth state of the process, it will be terminated state. And fifth state of the process, it will be waiting state. These are the five states of the process can be represented by this particular diagram. So first state of the process, it is new state. So if two or more processes are in new state, then the operating system, the part of operating system which is called as long-term scheduler, the long-term scheduler, it will store those processes in a queue, and name of that queue will be input queue. So let's say these are three processes which were created by the operating system. So those three processes will be stored in the input queue. Now, the process which is there in new state, it will be brought to the ready state. Second state, it is the ready state, by the operating system. The part of operating system which brings a process from new state to ready state, that is called as a long-term scheduler. It means process P1 which is in new state, it will be taken by the long-term scheduler, and the long-term scheduler, it will bring the process to the ready state. If there are more than two processes in the ready state, then this long-term scheduler, it will store those processes in a queue, and name of that queue will be ready queue. If more than two processes are there in the ready state, then the operating system will store those processes in a queue. That queue, name of that queue will be ready queue. So you see, a process which is in ready queue, it will be given to the CPU. It will be given to the CPU. If the process is given to the CPU, then the process can be in execution state. Then the process can be in execution state. And remember, the part of operating system which is taking a process from ready state or ready queue and giving it to the CPU for execution, that is called as the short term scheduler, or its another name is CPU scheduler. It means what the short term scheduler will do? The short term scheduler, it will take a process from ready state, and the process will be given to the CPU for execution. In between, and the software part, that is called as dispatcher, will be used. Let's see what's the function of dispatcher. The dispatcher, it will give start and stop instruction to the CPU. If the dispatcher gives start instruction to the CPU, then whichever process the CPU is having currently, the execution of that process will be started. So if a process is executing, then we will say that the process is in execution state. Now remember, an executing process, if it finishes execution, then after finishing execution, the process will be terminated by the operating system. And after terminating the process will enter in the terminated state. And remember, a terminated process will leave its memory, its process table from the memory will release it. Now, first situation with an executing process happened is the executing process, it finished the execution and it was terminated by the operating system. Second case can be, if the process wants to perform some I/O operation and the corresponding input-output device is not free, then in that situation, the part of operating system which will bring the process from execution state to the waiting state, that part of operating system will be called as the medium term scheduler. Means, if a process wants to perform, if an executing process wants to perform some I/O operation and the corresponding I/O device is not free, then the medium term scheduler, it will bring the process from execution state to the waiting state. If there are two or more processes in the waiting state, then the medium term scheduler, it will store those processes in a queue and name of that queue will be called as waiting queue. A process which is in waiting state, it cannot directly go to the execution state. Or a process which is in waiting state, it cannot directly be, cannot directly enter in the terminated state. This is why, what will happen? A waiting state process will be brought to the ready state by the operating system. And again, after bringing the process to the ready state, the process will be given to the CPU for execution. So, I am repeating the point. The execution state process, either it will enter intermediate state if it finishes execution, or it will come to the waiting state if the process wants to perform some I/O operation and the corresponding I/O device is not free. Third case can be an executing process can return back to the ready state. In which situation an executing process will return back to the ready state, I will explain. If a process is executing and another process which has higher priority than the executing process is arriving in the ready queue, in that situation, the currently executing process, it will be brought back by the short term scheduler or CPU scheduler to the ready state. And the new process which was having higher priority, that process will be given to the CPU for execution.